Ooh, pardon me, it's fucking cold. Coming outside, actually. I had two of these Domino's toppers. What the hell happened to the other one? Oh, there it is. Okay. I got worried for a moment it got stolen. Okay. Pardon my voice and just heavy breathing. I'm sick, and it's also really cold out. Got COVID for Christmas, but figured no time like the present, so here it is. Good old Hubert the Corolla. So let's give you a little walk around before I talk about the motor. I'm not great at these little vlog things, so you'll have to excuse me. I might dub over it later. So, this is an 89 Corolla AE92. Or more commonly, you see them as the Corolla GTS. But all the Corollas had shit like that. I bought the car for... Well, I got it with a trade deal for like $900. And with that trade deal, I traded my parts car, and that was worth, I had probably $1,100 invested in it. And I bought that car for, $900, and I fixed the starter motor on it, paid a shop $200 to do it because it was a bitch, didn't feel like it. Here we go. Let me pop the hood. So, let me preface this by saying when I first bought the car, I had my dad drive it home because I couldn't drive stick. And that was the whole point of this car, Hubert here. That's what my girlfriend and I decided to name him. Oh, man. Where's the latch? Oh, that's right. Yeah, it's misaligned. Well... Oh, there it is. So here's the engine bay. As you can see, there is no motor in here. And that's because the previous owner had, the story we were told, the guy turned out to be kind of a scammer. Real interesting character. Have to tell that story later, maybe for another time. But the guy had, tried to do a real lousy rebuild, and what resulted was we were driving home and just something wasn't quite right with the motor. The car had 150k miles on it, and it is an SR5 coupe, so it had the 4AF, not the FE, because it's an 89. We didn't get fuel injected. I believe it was until like 91, I think, or maybe it was like halfway through 90. I don't know. This car predates me. Maybe some older folks in the comments tell me with a little more knowledge. But yeah, I've had this car for about 6 months. First time pulling a motor on a car. And, I think these are the original stickers. I don't know. I want to say they are because of the little bits of like crust and shit around the side. The car is pretty dirty because it sat in a garage for about 6 months as we pulled the motor, but it's got little bits of rust here, but it doesn't leak, and that's what matters. But that's why I got this. I got this as a birthday gift about a month ago, and the worst parts of the front bumper are stuff like this, so you can kind of see it better. And, it's, like I said, it's little scuffs and stuff, but there's not a whole lot of fade. This looked much nicer when I bought it, but, with it sitting out, it sat outside for a good little while. I don't really care too much. I feel bad, but, what can you do? This is originally intended to be my daily driver, but, considering there's no motor in it, I'm sure you can tell how that went. Also that came on the car was these cheap, I don't know if you can see them back there, $300 Godspeed coilovers. They were rusted when I bought them, and me and my buddies tried to adjust them, but, you know, I've never actually owned a pair of coilovers on a car before. Never installed any. I just thought it was like, okay, cool. Because, you know, a lot of these old Toyotas, I've got an old Cressida and an old second-gen pickup. The struts and shit like that just blow. I don't know what it is. Well, it's all, I know what it is. Like, they're 32-year-old cars. They're fucking ancient. And, you know, wear and tear. But let me show off the inside a little bit here. I've been walking around talking to myself. Probably look like a fucking schizo to anybody that's not outside here. So I'm kind of a big guy, I'll be honest. So this car is pretty tiny for me. But I'd always kind of wanted an AE92. And specifically an AE92 because I was like, these give me all that 80s retro vibe of like what an AE86 would have, but like without the tax of owning an AE86, which I love. And, you know, I remember I drove it for the first time and I stalled it a bunch. Also could be the fact that the car just has no power. According to Google and some brochures and forums I've read, the car was supposed to make in the ballpark of about 90 horsepower when it was, you know, at its peak. So imagine like 150K miles of wear. The motor was rebuilt. It had new pistons in it, which I'm going to go show you actually right now. Here's the dashboard. It's cracked in most of the usual places that I see on these E90 Corolla dashboards. Well, more specifically, the coupe dashboards, where they crack like right here and there. And the previous owner tried to fill it. This is my mirror. I actually got this out of a E90 DX. I think it was like a 91 because it was fuel injected. 1.6. And then the previous owner had put in a, I want to say this is a radio from like a Ford Ranger or something. And then the panel behind me over here is kind of fucked up for the same reason. It had a seatbelt out of a Ford Ranger. And it was like, this had all been popped out and was just all kinds of fucked up. And I'm no restoree, but, you know, I did what I could with, you know, common hand tools. So this is a seatbelt out of an MR2. I want to say, I don't know what year. I'll probably put a picture up. And then the latch there, that is from the same Corolla that came out of. So, hell, man. I'm like, look at that, man. Big boy. Let me show you one last thing before I head over to the garage to show you the motor. So in here is a bunch of spare parts, shitty parts. Previous owner had just stripped out this whole trunk. I don't know what happened to the padding and where I'll get it, but I don't care too much. As you can see, though, you know, it's not rotting away or anything like that. The frame is, that is literally stuck to that. Oh my god. Okay, well that's cool. You can see it's not, you know, this is all dirt and grime and shit, but you can see that it's not rusted out. And if it is, there's surface rust. Like when I bought the car, the big rust spot that I noticed was right down here. That's about it. I've never had this car up on a lift. The previous owner had also done a lot of shoddy modifications to this thing. He had put his own little custom exhaust. It was a cherry bomb glass pack pipe with bunch of wood screws attached. And it just, you know, falling apart. I have a clip of it somewhere. I'll put it up on the screen.
Hit it!
When I first bought it, but it would backfire like a damn rally car. So, yeah, I'll take you down to the garage and show you what I've got, what I'm cooking with. All right. Let me get some lights on in here. If I remember what lights go to what. God, I haven't been down here in probably about 2 weeks. It's been so fucking sick. And it's just really cold. Okay, I guess that's all the light I have, but I guess it's good enough. So all this here is Toyota 7M GTE parts for my Cressida. I'm going to convert it to turbo, all this stuff here. But that's not really the focus of this video. Maybe I could address it another time. I don't know. I've never really done a car vlog type video before. But here's my motor. So this is a 1.6 4AFE bottom end out of a 94 Geo Prism. And I got it from a junkyard for $25. Had my dad take it to a machine shop. They just went through the whole thing. They, what is it called? They honed it. That's it. And then this is the same crank. The, all, you know, same stuff. The bottom end was pretty much fine. I think the motor had something like 90,000 miles in it. It just sat in a shed. So the head was rusted out, but the bottom end was... It had like a milkshake to it, but it was a recent sort of like thing. So it wasn't rusted out. It turned over fine. So there's that. And then over here is an amalgamation of different pistons. I don't know which ones are the old ones that the previous owner had put in. I don't even know. I might have thrown those out. I don't think I have the old block anymore. I think we sent that off to be scrapped. It was junk. It wasn't savable. It would need to be sleeved. So, yeah. This is the original 4AF carbureted head. And I decided to stick with a carbureted head just for the simplicity of it. And I don't really know enough about like harness and wiring stuff, as this is my first engine rebuild slash swap sort of thing. So I just wanted to keep it simple, keep the car running, you know. I'm not going to rice it out, you know. I just need something that'll, you know, a little canyon carver, a little back row bomber sort of situation. So as for this, I just got a little Christmas gift. It's all those gaskets and little... Well, you know, doohickeys that go with the timing cover and all that. This over here actually is the later valve cover, and I'm kind of debating if I want to use that one or the earlier one. I kind of like the earlier one because it's got kind of like a red text to it. Looks kind of cool, but as for a 4AGE conversion, I do have an idea. So there's this guy who has, I want to say, like an AW15 MR2, and it's got a red top in it. I know there's really no good way to distinguish between a red top and a blue top at that point. I don't know. I think it's a big port. I'm pretty sure it's a big port, and I was just thinking about getting the head off of that and just using this bottom end, but after doing some reading online, I would need the full bottom end, and with where it's at, it was just going to be kind of a pain, and especially with winter, you know, it's like 4 or 5 days until New Year's. It was just not going to be convenient for me to, you know, go take apart the back half of an MR2 and whatnot. I'll probably put a video up on the screen of that. I may not. I don't know. I've also just got a new phone, so that's why I'm kind of making this little video. But that kind of concludes a little garage tour, sort of car tour situation. I guess I got one last thing I could sort of show off on the Corolla that I don't think many people actually have here. I'm going to show you guys, this is pretty neat. So, on my particular SR5 coupe, I don't know what the story is behind these, but, you know, me and my buddies have been, you know, we found it pretty cool. Oh, come on. There we go. On the Corolla, there is these kind of cool wheels. They kind of remind me of, like, old kind of like BMW BBS wheels. I thought they were kind of cool, so I'm gonna keep them on there. I don't know if they're from the factory or not, but yeah, these are from West Germany, which is, you don't know, that place doesn't exist anymore. Open a little history book. They're made by a company called Intra, I-N-T-R-A, and I thought that was pretty fucking cool. I looked them up, and I looked up the wheels, and I found literally nothing, so... Well, I found the company, but I couldn't find what model these were, or anything like that. And these mirrors, I thought these were really cool. These are actually stock on the car, so... But, yeah, I think, I think it's going to wrap up the little tour here of Hubert, the AE92. I'll keep you posted. I'm hoping to have this car back on the road before summertime. Like, call it May 2023. I don't know. If you guys like this, let me know in the comments. I'm not, like I said, I'm not great with these little vlog sort of things. But, you know, have a good one. What's up, guys? On my fifth tour of Iraq here with Sergeant Patterson. We got Private E4 homosexual.
I tell you what, bub. I tell you what, isn't that right, Dylan? Isn't that right? Yep, Mountain Dew.
What are you doing? We are just connecting the motor. We are we're not right in. All right. So.